We all know the cats always land on their feet, but how far can a cat fall and still survive? Humans that fall over 10 stories have about a 5% chance of surviving. Cats falling from the same height have about a 5% chance of dying. Now, this doesn't mean to take your cat and throw her out a window, because, well, biologists have already done that. In a study of 132 cats that accidentally fell out of buildings, 90% of them survived. One cat actually fell 32 stories and landed on a concrete sidewalk, and only suffered a chipped tooth and a collapsed lung. What's even more interesting is the farther that the cat falls, the higher its chances of surviving. Now, at first, this is kind of counterintuitive. The farther you fall, the faster you'll accelerate and the harder you'll hit the ground. So how can a cat falling from 10 stories have a higher chance of surviving than a cat falling at 3 stories? Well, the answer to that question is terminal velocity. Terminal velocity occurs when the air resistance of the air you're falling through equals the gravitational force that's pulling you down. Essentially, you stop accelerating due to gravity. Unfortunately for humans, this speed is about 120 miles per hour. But for cats, it's half that, at 60 miles per hour. But that doesn't really explain why cats falling at 10 stories have a higher chance of surviving than a cat falling at 3 stories. And that has to do with the fact that cats can actually sense acceleration. When a cat's falling and accelerating downward, it can sense that. It has a sense that is able to detect whether it's accelerating or not. When the cat is not accelerating anymore, aka reaches terminal velocity, it relaxes its body more and the impact is not as rigid. Now, let's walk through a hypothetical situation of a cat falling off of a skyscraper. The cat jumps off, rotates herself around so her feet are underneath her. At this point, she's kind of freaking out because she can feel the gravity accelerating her downward. Her limbs are tightened up, and if she were to hit the ground at this point, she would suffer more injuries due to her stiffened body. But as she falls farther, she reaches terminal velocity, stops accelerating, and spreads out and kind of glides through the air. The more she spreads out, the slower she'll fall because of terminal velocity and the air resistance. The more you spread out, the more air hits you and the slower you'll actually fall. At this point, if she were to hit the ground, she could hit the ground with her legs slightly bent to absorb the impact, and she would essentially walk away unscathed and hit the catnip. Thanks for watching this video, and if you liked it, please thumbs up and share with your friends. Don't forget to subscribe for future videos, and if you have any questions, just leave a comment in the comment section below, and I'll be happy to answer. I'll see you guys next week.